I did say that, you know, I'm oversimplifying and there are a few other things. So there are a few other bits that can go with this other information that we're talking about. In particular, there's an interesting thing called SetUID, and maybe, you know, we want to talk about this a little bit. So think about a game program, okay, that needs to update a file that stores the scores of different people who have played this game. So when these people are playing the game, of course, we want to be able to update that file. When your score increases, you want to update your score that's in there. So these users, while playing the game, when they play the game, need to have write access to that file. When they're not playing the game, we don't want them to have write access, because then they can go change the score without playing the game. So we don't want that. So how can we solve this problem? These systems I'm talking about, this problem is solved by having something called a set UID bit. So the way to understand this is that we have Alice and Bob owns the game file. And Alice wants to play the game. So the game file actually is owned by Bob, and Bob is going to give permission to Alice to execute, be able to execute this file. By the way, the score file is also, Bob is going to own the score and is not going to grant write access to Alice, because Alice should not be able to update that file unless he's playing the game. So you can think about the score file. Alice can read it, her score and somebody else's score, how people are doing, but she can't write it. Bob can read-write it because Bob owns the game file that we have here. He's some special user or someone who's running this program that we have. People want to play the game. So setUID bit is set on the game file, the executable file that we have. And we said Alice executes this file when she wants to play the game. So setUID bit, when it's set on an executable file, actually does an interesting thing. When Alice executes this file, the user ID temporarily changes from Alice to Bob. Okay, so it says when a setUID file is executed, the user ID, effective user ID at that point, is not the user who actually executed the file, but is owner of this file. In this case, the owner of the file is Bob. So during the execution of the game, although Alice is playing the game, during the execution of the game, the temporary or effective UID is Bob. And because of that, even though Alice is playing the game, she is able to update the file. File is updated by that is in this game file. And while we are executing the game file, as we said, the effective user ID becomes Bob. Alice launched this program, but the program is owned by somebody else. This change in UID is possible when the executable file that Alice executes, the game file here, has the set UID bit set. So the set UID bit is used to change the UID temporarily during the execution of the program on which this bit is set. And I hope I motivated why you may want to do that in this case, for example, the game file that we're talking about.